Hello, my name's Garth Amott. I'm in Grand Rapids, Michigan, and I like fixing Disney snow globes. Picked up the hobby, and I've fixed probably 20 or 30 so far, and I get joy out of it.
So there are two steamboats. They're the 75th anniversary on both. Both had Dumbo's right ear broken off in different places. But luckily, one of them had the ear that was broken off. So I'm going to use that to clone another. This one's missing Pinocchio's left arm. This one has the left arm. This one had the Br'er Rabbit's head. This one was missing Br'er Rabbit's head. I've already fixed that. So what I did obviously was I made a silicone cast of the original head and then reformatted it and put it on this rabbit. I haven't fixed the neck yet. The neck you'll notice has a really thick collar of plaster around. I'm gonna try to smooth that out and then paint that to match his skin and shirt. It's not perfect, but it's darn close. So that's the goal. Also, one of them has a working music box. And one of them does not. I was able to purchase a new music box. It's still in its case, but that's going to be put on the old one. Both of them have functioning, although one's not plugged in, but both of them have functioning. Let me find where the button is. There it is. Both of them have functioning blowers and lights in the wheelhouse. So by combining the defects of one with the assets of the other and trading off where they're missing or better, we should have two completed ones when we're done. It's a very cute one, too. I'll just show you. It's got Mowgli and Baloo. It's got the three little pigs, which is one of my favorite of their shorts. It's got the Cheshire Cat. And on this side, it's got, obviously, Snow White and a couple of the dwarves. And Pinocchio and Figaro. And the back is a... This one's also, by the way, missing a little leg on the bottom. I can fix that. And they came very dirty, but they cleaned up nicely. So these are defects that can be fixed. All right, here's the plan. We have Dumbo's ear. It's broken off. It's here. I've got another ear that's broken off in a different angle here. And so I'm going to take this mostly original ear, and we're going to cast it, and then we can use some milliputty, whatever it's called, to put it back on both sides, on both elephants. We'll see if it works. Okay, so inside this cocoon is the ear. I'm going to be able to grab it and pull it out once this cures. It takes about 20-25 minutes, and hopefully the cavity inside is the exact same shape. I squeezed around the ear and wrapped and folded, and hopefully that's going to work. If not, we can use a liquid method. All right, so I cast a resin ear. Can't really use plaster because plaster is so brittle on a thin piece like this that it breaks, even if it's cast perfectly. So what I do is I pour resin. Sometimes I'll put a little color in it so that it's easier to see. Now the challenge is to take that ear that has been cast and put it on this broken elephant's gap. So I've ground them down so they're darn close. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use the milliput right there to adhere it. Problem is I'm gonna have to hold it for a few minutes. Milliput takes a couple hours to dry. So I'll rig some kind of little holding gear up there. Just try to hold it on long enough for it to hold well, and then let it harden. When it hardens, it's as good as ceramic. And this is going to be a pretty close match.
course, it'll be painted first, so I'm going to paint it to try to match this ear, so it'll be pretty close. And I can, what I then do is I'll sometimes put a little plain old plaster putty into any cracks that are still showing, try to sand it down so it's looking good, and then we'll be done with this one.
I just want to add, one of the important tools that I have found very helpful is a cordless. I have them corded too, if it's a heavier job, but this is a cordless Tack Life 2-speed. Easy to change chuck, different chucks for drilling, grinding. This is a polishing or a sanding one, but it helps to make very small projects. So once this little hand arm, let's get it the right way here. This is going to be Pinocchio's hand and arm that will go on his little missing arm here. But to get that kind of detail and sculpting, once I did the main cast, then those little tools come in real handy.
I'm just going to add parenthetically here that you can do a lot of things with creative ideas. I bought this Beauty and the Beast snow globe for my granddaughter. It was gorgeous. Unfortunately, it was missing Lumiere. Excuse me, who had broken off. And there was no piece to replace. So I went online and I found a little plastic Lumiere that was about the same size. It was about 2 1/4 inches. Bought it, cast it, found out I couldn't use plaster. Too small, arms broke off. But once it was done, it's not like the original, so this diminishes the value if I ever want to sell it, but it would also diminish the value if there was no Lumiere. So by casting this Lumiere out of resin and painting it, it was good to go. You can do the same with missing pieces. Brer Rabbit, in this case, I had a second one to cast, but you could have used a toy. Might have been possible and could have worked. So getting back to Steamboat Mickey here, at this point, everything's been done. The ears seem to be holding real well. Of course, these are delicate things. That's why they put blowers in them, so that you don't have to pick them up and shake them. They're heavy. But the ears came out well. The one on the left, I didn't have to get into because the music box worked. So that one still has an air bubble in it. It's not huge. The one on the right, though, since I had it open anyway, I use a large, it's a huge big needle that you just put the solution in that you're going to inject, slip it in between the glass and the rubber gasket, and tilt it so that the air can escape while you inject the water in. So the one on the right's been actually fully repaired. The bubble was taken out, music box installed, and the one on the left I may still do that with. I didn't have to get into it, so I didn't bother. The bubbles don't make a big difference in the value, unless they're huge bubbles, then they do. So anyway, that is how these came out, and I think they came out good. Here's a short little video to conclude.